I come out here to, oh, hi people. I come out here to have a smoke and a coffee. But then I just saw some people pull up with the trailers outside our front. Okay, what it is, guys, what it is, we have a rubbish collection every year, and every house, like I think every different suburb in Perth all have different times during the year of throwing out the unwanted furniture. Anyway, it's our turn, so all the houses in our area, they get like rid of all their crap. I'm talking about like freaking dining tables, lounge suites, bedroom suites, TVs, fridges, washing machines, dryers, just all this unwanted furniture that they don't want, and they just chuck it out, just like what I done. I chucked out so much crap. I got all of our rubbish, which we done last Sunday, so it's been out there for weeks. So I got these people out there now, going for our rubbish. So every house on our street has all got their rubbish put out, waiting for the truck to pick it up. So but I don't have a problem with that, people. I don't have a problem with people going through finding whatever they can find. It's only when they leave a big fucking mess. When they leave a mess. I have been out there when I first took our rubbish out. I've been out there a number of times just to go and straighten up that crap after people have been through it, because they just like basically go through your crap and just throw everything around. So it just means I've got to go back out there and clean it up. Well, not clean it up, but straighten it up. But yeah, I've got some people out there. I've got some people out there now that's going through our rubbish. So I'm going to wait till they get. I know they didn't tidy it up. It's a pain in the ass. So thank God we got our, they come in tomorrow to pick up all the rubbish, because it's been out there for a week. But I mean, with the amount of furniture that people throw out, and especially in the, like in the well-to-do areas, you can furnish your whole freaking house out. But yeah, I mean, even carpets, they throw out carpets and rugs and pots and pans, everything that people don't want, so they just put it out onto the verge for the rubbish truck to come pick it up. But because it's there for a week, people go around with their trailers and their trucks, just basically scavenging through the rubbish to see what they could find. Like I said, I don't have a bloody problem with them getting whatever they want. It's when they just leave a whole freaking damn mess. So, but yeah, I'm gonna go out there. No use putting the sign out there and saying, can you just put things back, or just don't make a mess, because they just don't take no notice. So, but anyway, I didn't come in here to moan about that. I actually come in here because I'm going to put a couple of videos up onto this video for my, it's my grandson's birthday. He turned 5 on Friday, and his parents had his birthday party yesterday. Oh man, it was an awesome party. He had eight of his little school friends, of his little class friends, that came yesterday. It was so cute too. It was really, really cute seeing all of his little buddies, all his little class buddies there. And then he had his first cousins, so I think there would have been about 14 kids altogether. So it was a bloody busy. It was really busy. It was a lot of people there too. Like we had our family, we had all our family. Only one that was missing was Sunny and Jess, but that was because my daughter-in-law's father, it was her father's 60th birthday yesterday, so they couldn't come back. They came down to wish Isra a happy birthday, and also brought his little prezi down for him. Yeah, they were the only ones that went there yesterday, but everybody else was. Isra had like the three grandparents there, including myself, so he was really lucky. He had his grandparents there as well, because he had his biological father, his mum and his sister came down, and his first cousin that is on their side. So that was the first time he met his first cousin on his, I don't know, what would you call it? Sperm donor. So, but oh, either way, it was awesome. He had an awesome time. Heaps of food and heaps of lollies. All the kids went home like on a high. High is quite because there was so much bloody sweets there. But yeah, so it was a really awesome. So I'm gonna throw a couple of videos and some photos that I'd taken of the birthday. So yeah, so man, it's so hot today, people. I went for my walk this morning. I need to go early in the morning while it was still a little bit coolish, because now that sun is just like beaming down. It's so bloody hot. So this is so typical of spring weather. Spring. And the date is the 8th of September, Sunday. I'm going to go and have a quick nap before I can pick up my son. He's also with my other son. He spent the night with him last night. And yeah. So yeah, anyway, people, I'm getting really hot out here. So if you like this video, you know what to do. Give me a like, comment down below if you want. Also the notification, and also subscribe, so I'll catch you in my next video. So bye. Bye.
You got him, Paul. All right, two times and that's it.
Okay.